turn another fraction into a decimal? Well, at least the denominator is small, so this should be easy. We know how to handle this. We just divide the 7 into the 3. Take the 7 into the 3. Of course, 7 doesn't go into 3, and we need some tenths. 7 into 30, that goes 4 times. 4 times 7 is 28. And we have 2 left over. So we need hundredths. 7 into 20, that goes 2 times. 2 times 7 is 14. That leaves us 6 left over. Need another 0. 7 into 60, that goes 8 times. 8 times 7 is 56. That gives us 4 left over. Still not repeating. All right, another 0. 7 into 40, that gives us 5. 5 times 7 is 35. And that gives us 5 left over. Still not repeating. What's going on here? How do we know this is going to repeat? I'm going to stop and think about this a little bit because, I mean, for all we know, this could just go on forever and ever and ever and not repeat. And I can tell you who likes doing things forever. Not this guy. Not me. So I want to think about this and make sure it's actually going to repeat rather than just continuing on and on blindly. Now, when I'm dividing 7 in here, I don't have that many options for what can be left over. If I hit a 0, that means the decimal terminates and we're finished, and we'd like to be finished. If we don't get a 0 at this division, we'll have some amount left over. So we had 2 left over, then 6 left over, then 4 left over. Now we got 5 left over. Well, we can only have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6 left over. We can't have anything other than that, other than the 0, and at 0 we'd be done. That would be great. But other than that, we'll have 1 through 6. Those are the only options. So if I keep on going like this, I'm eventually going to hit one of these a second time. Eventually, I'm going to hit one of these 2 or 6 or 4 or 5 or even back where we started with the 3. I'll hit one of those for a second time, and that's when I know we'll start repeating. We'll start repeating. And since I only have 6 possibilities, that's not many, eventually I know I'm going to hit one for a second time. So I know this is going to repeat eventually. I hope it's soon. Let's continue. We bring down a 0, 7 into 50. That goes 7 times. 7 times 7 is 49. And that gives us 1 left over, still not a repeat. Bring down the 0. 7 into 10, that just goes once. 1 times 7 is 7. And that gives us 3 left over, so 7 into 3. 7 into 3, that's where we started. We started with 7 into 3. So we're repeating a division here. 7 into 3, we'll bring down a 0. 7 goes into 30, 4 times, but now we're repeating. That would be 4 times, we'll have 2 left over when we subtract 28 from 30. 7 will go into 20 then twice, and then we'll have 6 left over, and on and on and on. We're repeating. We're going right down this chain again, starting down here. 7 and 30, 28, and we'll just continue on. We'll get 4, then 2, then 8, then 5, and we'll repeat this block of 6 numbers over and over and over. So we've turned this fraction into the repeating decimal, 428571. We'll just repeat those 6 digits over and over, 428571, 428571, on and on and on. Now on your own, check out the other 7s. Try 1/7, 2/7, 4/7, 5/7, 6/7. You should see a pretty cool pattern in what happens in these digits. And just what we did here with 7, dividing 7 into 3, we can do that with any denominator. Divide the denominator into the numerator. If we hit a 0 while we're doing that division, then we terminate. The decimal terminates. But if it doesn't hit a 0, it's eventually going to repeat because there are only so many things that can be left over. So you're eventually going to start repeating that division. And you'll end up with a repeating decimal if you don't have a terminating one. So let's see. Now we know how to turn, a terminating decimal into a fraction. We know how to turn a fraction into either a terminating or a repeating decimal. But can we always take a repeating decimal and turn that back into a fraction? Let's check that out next. ¶¶